And I don't know, we're getting a little internet interruption today, but you know what? Ain't nothing going to stop today because you know what it is. It's the one and only. It's a king's birthday. You know what it is. Welcome to the Chosen Not Taken show. It's a special, special show today because it's my birthday. You heard me? Like Squirrel Business, though, all the way from Louisiana. You know what I'm saying? But residing in Dallas, Texas now. It's my birthday. Let's turn up. Don't turn nothing down. Don't take nothing off. You know what I'm saying? Because we finna take off just like a plane on the runway, you dig? Let me tell you something, man. It's a blessing to be alive. I'm wide open. I'm ready for tonight. Tonight is a special show because I just want to let you know, man, if you don't know nothing else, just know that God is good. But guess what, though? In the great words of my boy, big shout out to DJ Will. I might be saved, but guess what, though? I'm still a little wretched, though. Yeah, boom, boom, boom. I gotta show y'all a different side of me tonight. I gotta show y'all a little something different about me tonight. You know what I'm saying? Say sanctified and wretched with it too. Let me tell you something. I don't know about y'all, but if y'all ain't excited for life, man, get away from me. That's all I'm gonna tell you. Get away from me. I don't wanna talk. You heard me? Like Squirrel Business, though. I don't wanna talk. That's how I'm feeling today. If you ain't celebrating me with me, I don't want to talk. I'm gonna be honest with you, man. That's the problem with a lot of us, man. We let too many people hold on to us. Your energy is too great. You too happy. I hate to hear people talking about you too happy. Yeah, that's what it is. Well, welcome to the Chosen Not Taken show. I am your host, Real Rut, aka Chosen Not Taken. Choose your life. Don't take what life gives you, man. Go take your life. Happy 37th birthday to the one and only King himself, man. If you look up my name Roy stands for King in French. So when you tell me happy birthday, Roy, just like you saying happy birthday, King, I just want a big shout out to everybody that showed me some love today. Man, I love y'all from the bottom of my heart. I'm excited for life. You feel what I'm saying? Because you don't know my story. Don't ask me why I'm so turned up. Don't ask me that. Because if you knew my story, you wouldn't even have to ask me that. You'll start dancing when you see me. If you knew my story. But a lot of y'all don't know my story. You feel what I'm saying? So when a hater got something to say about you, feel sorry for him. I really feel sorry for him. Pray for him. Because you know why? Because they just don't know what you've been through. They don't know what you overcame. They don't know what you've been through. They don't know who they dealing with. Because they couldn't see what you saw in yourself. Yeah, you know what it is, what it ain't, man. Welcome to the Chosen Not Taken show. I am your host, Real Rub, man. We represent because today is a special, special show because, you know, it's the King's birthday today. You heard me? Like Squirrel Business, though. It's a Louisiana boy birthday, man. A happy 37th birthday to myself. I know I don't look 37. I know I look a little young and everything, but it's up there. You heard me? It's up there and it's stuck there. You know what I'm saying? Well, I don't even know what we're going to talk about today. Day Famous Friday. Anybody want to come on with me today, just shoot me the request. We're going to get on today. We turning up today. I'm gonna do, you know, I gotta do a little Louisiana before I do anything, before I go back to my R&B. You know what it is and what it ain't, man. Happy, man, appreciate all the love, appreciate the gifts. That's what's happening, man. You know what it is and what it ain't. What's happening, everybody? I hope everybody having a wonderful and blessed day. What's going on? Kyle, what's up with you, baby? Oh, y'all telling me happy birthday, but y'all ain't let me know where y'all telling me happy birthday from. Where y'all from? Don't just tap in, you know. Let me know where you're coming from too. You know what it is and what it ain't. That's it, man. Man, I'm blessed, man. I'm blessed. You know what it is. We got to get a little ratchet before the show gets started tonight, man. You know what it is and what it's not. Man, a beautiful, beautiful day outside. I'm talking about Dallas, Texas. The weather was on point. I woke up this morning in a good spirit and good health. Shreveport, Louisiana in the building. What's happening with you? Don't y'all get me started tonight. Yeah. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Let's go, let's go, let's go. Well, that's what I'm saying. You don't know what it is. Baby, do it, a do it, a sticky, a do it, a sticky, a do it, a sticky, a do it. Let me tell y'all something. Y'all can act all saved and sanctified if y'all want to, but I know y'all got some ratchet in y'all. I know y'all got some ratchet in y'all. I know y'all do. I know y'all got some ratchet in y'all. Shaking they caboose. I'm talking about, I just got to give a few minutes to just get ratchet for a minute. Man, it's a king's birthday today. I don't know about y'all. Let me tell you something. I wouldn't care if it were number zero people on this line right now. I'm still going to turn up for me. See, I appreciate me. Matter of fact, I want everybody to look themselves in the mirror. Go get you a mirror. If you're not driving, if you're in your house, go look in the mirror and say, man, I love me. I don't need nobody else to love me. I love me. I don't need no validation from nobody else. I'm turned up for me. I don't need nobody else. I turn up for me. And see, that energy is contagious. I do it. I stick it, baby, do it. Man, I so appreciate all the birthday love. I so appreciate all the birthday love. I appreciate it. I appreciate it. I appreciate it. Man, you know I'm a Louisiana boy to the fullest. Man, if y'all don't think for 1 second that I wasn't a DJ in my past life, something wrong with y'all. You know what I'm saying? Boom, boom, boom. I just want to know one thing. I just want to know one thing. I don't know about y'all. I know y'all don't club no more. But back when you was in the club, you know you used to hear the DJ say, I don't mean to start no ride. All the ugly women in the house, be quiet. Yeah, 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 yeah. Come on now, what's up? Appreciate the happy birthday love. I appreciate the happy birthday love. You know what it is? It's April the 8th, man. It's a King's Day. You feel what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? It's a King's Day today. You feel what I'm saying? I'm just telling y'all, man, listen, if y'all think tonight's show ain't finna be off the chain, it's finna be unreal. I'm gonna have my little teaching session. You know I got to teach y'all a little something before we turn all the way up. But let me let you know something, man. Y'all don't understand what I've been through. That's why I'm turning up. I don't need nobody else to turn up with me. I turn up by myself. You feel what I'm saying? Because guess what? Let me tell you something. Every day is my birthday. I'm just solidifying it today because this is the day that my mother gave birth to me. This is the day that God chose for me to be in the world. But baby, let me tell you something. My birth came when I was grown. Come on now, I'm just telling you what's real now. Come on now. My birth came when I was grown. After I had been through something. You feel what I'm saying? When I had been through something. And then I was born again. Come on now, you ain't feeling what I'm saying. It's two important days of a man's life. It's the day that he was born and the day that he learned why, the reason why. Come on, man. You ain't feeling what I'm saying. It's the day that you were really born naturally. And then spiritually you realize why you was put here. See, them the 2 days that's so important. It's the rebirth. You got it. You know what it is, brown eyes. Talk to me now. Yeah, 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 yeah. Now, see, you know, I got too old now, so, you know, my knees and started hurting. So, I got to slow this thing down here. Hold on. Okay, Google, play R. Kelly Dedicated. I got to slow this thing down. Slow this thing down. Drink me some of the good water. They got me over here sweating. Let me cut my AC up. Hold on.
Dedicated by R. Kelly, playing on YouTube Music.
Yeah, man, I had to cut the AC up a little bit up in here. Cut the AC down a little bit. It makes sense. How your knee hurting? You ain't stand up. I wouldn't dare stand up. You know, man, them people are already reporting me for nudity. I had a whole shirt on. Not cut the AC. Cut the AC down. You know what it is. I'm telling you, man. Listen, let me tell you something, man. Let me explain something to y'all, man. First of all, let me start the show out by saying this here. I just want to tell everybody from the bottom of my heart. Listen to what I'm saying. I want you to hear me well. I want to tell everybody thank you so much. Everybody that thought about me, everybody that pressed like on my video, everybody that cashed out me, everybody that even pointed me out, Anointed Billionaire Queen, I appreciate you. I love the video you made. Listen, man, I love y'all so much. I appreciate y'all. You know what I'm saying? Y'all the reason why I do what I do. You feel what I'm saying? You feel what I'm saying? I want y'all to know something, man. This is what I do for love. I do this out of pure D love. You feel what I'm saying? I do this out of pure D love. And I appreciate that. That's why it says, you don't attract what you want, you attract what you are. And I believe that everybody on here has a heart to do better in life. Everybody on here has a heart to love people. Everybody on here has a heart to do better and better and better and better. You feel what I'm saying? it's not everybody kept asking me today. It was like, what's your plans is? Man, I'm doing my show tonight. They were like, you're not doing nothing else? Listen, I went to work this morning. I'm adulting. Let's get this cleared up. I'm adulting. I'm 37 years old. 37. I'm blessed. You know what I'm saying? People don't like to have these conversations, but you was only promised 70. All right. You feel what I'm saying? You was only promised 70. Anything after 70 is extra. You feel what I'm saying? You was only promised 70. You know what I'm saying? You only promised 70, and I'm 37, so therefore I'm 2 years over halfway. You don't have no more time to waste, baby. I want to encourage somebody today to know this here, man. You don't have no more time to waste. Whatever gift you have, whatever it is that you really truly want to do, go do it. Don't waste no more of your time. Don't waste any more of your time on meaningless things. Don't waste any more of your time on meaningless things. Nothing else. I want you to hear me well. Don't waste your time on meaningless things, things that do not matter. Because you are great. You deserve everything that you really and truly want. You deserve everything that you really and truly want. If you want something, go get it. But it's not going to be handed to you because life does not owe you anything. When I hit rock bottom 5 years ago, I didn't blame nobody. I didn't look for nobody. I just put my faith in God and put my head down and go to work. Because guess what? Faith without works is dead. And then I went to the book of Psalms. Go to the book of Psalms, the first chapter in the book of Psalms. And I realized what a man was. To be careful about who I hang with. And that's the topic for tonight. Don't expect people to see what you see. Don't expect people to see what you see. You got to get out this mind frame that you going to bring along everybody. You're not. You need to learn how to open your hand up and let go. But the things that you let go of are the things that hurt you the most. Come on, man. Those are the things you need to let go of. Let go of the things that hurt you the most. And hold on to the things that help you. What hurts my feelings so much, it really hurts my feelings that every time I do a one-on-one session, I talk to people and, you know, they tell me what's going on with them. I can see that they gave their heart out. They gave their heart out to somebody, or they gave up their dreams for somebody, or they gave up their dreams to help somebody, or they gave up their future for somebody. Baby, don't do that no more. Focus on you, because let me tell you something. If you focus on your dreams, you focus on your future, I promise you, you're going to make everybody else around you better. Psalms 1, go there. Go to Psalms 1. If any man in your life, if you want him to know what a man is, go to Psalms 1. Go to Psalms 1. It ain't got number 6 verses in it. and one of them scriptures, you know, I ain't the smartest man in the world, but one of them scriptures say you have to be planted. Come on, it say you have to be planted like a tree by the water. Okay. Planted by the tree by the, like a tree by the water. The reason why he say planted by the tree by the water is because notice how they put that. Planted by a tree by the water. Come on, man. Don't they tell you to hold on to God's unchanging hand? So if you holding on to their hand, they put you in the mindset of a child and an adult, right? So when a little child hold on to their hand, they hold on to it, right? Hold on to God's unchanging hand, being planted like a tree by the water. You better feel what I'm saying. You got to get to a point to where you planted in your faith. You got to get to a point that where you planted on who you're going to be. You got to get to a point to where you planted on your future. You plan it on the woman that you're going to become, the man that you become, the mother that you're going to become, the wife that you're going to become, the husband you're going to become, the father you're going to become, the best friend you're going to become. What's up, Philly Pretty? What's happening with you, baby? I just want you to know something. You got to get to the point in life to where, notice in the book of Psalms, just read that. When you get a chance to read Psalms 1, the 6th verse, just read that. When he said that a man should stay awake, he should only what? Seek wise counsel. He only should be around those with wise counsel. You got to stop being around people that's dummies. Oh yeah, I had to break it down real simple. You got to stop being around people that's dummies. And it's a difference between being a dummy and just not knowing. You feel me? It's okay to be ignorant. You know what I'm saying? But one thing about ignorance is that it's the lack of not knowing. Okay, it's the fact. But dummies, what do they do? Crash dummies, you put them in a car and they crash. You're going to have to get away from crash dummies. You got to start thinking of yourself in a more of a sense of, I'm not finna crash out with you. Because they can't see what you see. You're going to have to tell some people, I don't do that no more. Come on, man. I'm just showing you. I just want to let you know. I want y'all to feel something. I'm going to break something out to you. Stuff happened right before your... Don't be that person. Don't be that person. I'm just saying, don't be that crash dummy. Let me tell you something. I was on the road to becoming a crash dummy. That's why I could talk about it. So, you know what I'm saying? You know, I could really and truly tell you about how I've been a crash dummy. If you notice one thing, I said that I was not going to drink on my live no anymore. And I have not took a drink on my live, and outside of that, I ain't even had a drink since then. Because I see where I'm going. You got to get to a point to where it's not about what's wrong with something. You got to find out what's right about it. You feel what I'm saying? You got to get to the point to where you say, what's right about it? Like, what am I doing this for? We get to a point that, well, when you really and truly realize who you are and what God really and truly wants you to be, you open your eyes up and say, why am I doing that? He said, if you're faithful over a few things, I'll make you rule over many. See, he said, if you're faithful over a few things, I'll make you rule over many. See, baby, when you go to that gym and you faithful to that gym, you come back and you own the room. You own them pair of jeans that you couldn't get into. You own them workout tights. No, in the come on now, you own them. You know what I'm saying? You become a ruler over them, baby. Let me just say, you know what I'm saying? When you know what I'm saying? When you've been faithful in that gym and you've been consistent on your diet and you've been doing what you had to do, you own that 2-piece bathing suit. You know what I'm saying? You become a ruler over your appearance. You feel what I'm saying? Because you're faithful over it. Okay, check this out. When you've been faithful over a few things and make you rule over many, let me show you what happened. When you take control of yourself, you take control of your money situation, so therefore you rule where you spend money at. You ain't just spending just to spend it. You become disciplined. He says a fool and his money should soon depart, and you constantly departing for something. Yeah, see, that's the breakup you really need to be crying over, but we gonna keep that at a 2. We ain't gonna go too far on that. The reason why it's so important for you to take control of your life and say that you are more valuable than what you're doing, because you are not a person of circumstances. You are a person of your habits. You're not a person of circumstances, you're a person of your habits. Because if you have good habits, when circumstances come that way, you know how to deal with them a lot better. Because all you got to do is readjust your habits. Let me tell you, y'all thought I was just going to play all day. No. That ain't why y'all love me. Y'all love me because I come over here and talk with some sense. I'm going to get my jokes in, I'm going to do all that. What's up, Miss Free? What's happening with you? You know what I'm saying? I think, you know what I'm saying? I know y'all wouldn't come over here and play. I know y'all thought I was going to be turned up to the fullest, but man, my purpose and my gift is to teach. You feel what I'm saying? The jokes and stuff, all fine and dandy, but at the end of the day, life goes on. You could play for, notice what I did. I played for a minute, but this is serious business because I really want to see y'all become the best version of y'all selves. You feel what I'm saying? Whoever hears the sound of my voice, I want them to get better. I don't want to be a person that's a play. Now I got some purpose. And see, that's what you fail to realize is that I have to serve something. Come on, man. I'm just telling you what's real. You got to get to a point in your life. I want you to hear me what I'm saying. Get to a point to where the word I means so much to you. Before you say the word I, you know what you stand for. Come on now. You know what I'm saying? Let me show you how important the letter I is. You know what I'm saying? The letter I is, when you use the word I, you got to remember what he said when he was out there on the mountain, and he said, who am I supposed to say who brought me this? He said, tell him I am. So when the next time you say I am, okay, know that you bring something positive behind that. Don't say nothing. I don't want to hear no more I am not. You know what I'm saying? The only time you supposed to say I am not like that anymore. I am not doing that anymore. But don't tell me that I am not wealthy. I am not beautiful. I am not handsome. That shouldn't come out your mouth no more. Because from this point on, you should think that much of yourself. See, I told you, I'm a confidence coach. I don't believe in, I could be in a room with anybody. The reason why I could be in a room with anybody, because I know one thing, I'm secure in myself. And I always remember, insecure people can't be around secure people. See, only people that's insecure say things like, oh, they think they all that. Well, baby, I am. I am all that because I was perfectly and wonderfully made. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? That's just being real. I just want to let you know something, baby. Just because you don't drink coffee, that don't mean Starbucks going out of business. Come on, talk to me now. Hello, somebody. Yeah, just because you don't drink coffee, that don't mean that Starbucks going out of business. Okay, then. Hello, somebody. I'm going to say it again for those in the back. Just because you don't drink coffee, that don't mean that Starbucks is going out of business, baby. Just because I ain't your cup of tea, that don't mean this one here ain't hot enough to get, help somebody from being sick. Come on, you ain't feeling what I'm saying. I just want you to think that much of yourself. It's nothing wrong with having confidence. We live in a society to where we only think that people with money and people with this and that, they can only have confidence. No. I got confidence because I know where I'm going. I know who I am and where I'm going. That's why I got confidence. The reason I got so much confidence in all that is because I know who I serve. Because I serve a God that told me that. He told me off the rip, you know what I'm saying? He told me exactly what he had, what kind of plans he had for me. He told me everything's going to work for the good. But then when you go to the book of Psalms, I've been in the book of Psalms today. I had to get on my man tip today. And he said that I just want to make my words delightful. Come on, man. I just want to, he said, be like delightful and meditate on my word daily. Come on, man. I just want to say that. That's Psalm 19 is about just make sure my words are pleasing in Psalm 19. But in Psalms 1, he said, you're supposed to pray and meditate on my word daily. See, it's a difference when you say you pick up the book and read. Okay, that's cool. All right, that's cool. Like, you know, I read the book. Okay, but did you get an understanding? Okay, see, that's what meditation come in at. See, he said, pray and meditate on my word daily. He ain't tell you nothing about just read. If you notice something, the Bible says study to show who, to show thyself approved. So studying, meditating, none of this just skimming through stuff. See, that's why I'm different. I'm not here to tell you, oh, I read this. Well, I studied this. Cause see, when you, it's a difference between people that read something. I can get you to stand up and read something, and you can't tell me what they were saying. But when you study it, you know it. That's why he say study to show thyself approved. That means show me that you got approval to say that you're a Christian. Show me you got approval that you say you are who you say you are. Come on, man, you gotta have approval. You gotta have some identification. Like, who is you? You just run around here claiming. Let me tell you something. You can't. You even in the streets, you just can't go and represent a neighborhood or a gang unless you got some proof. Cause they gonna ask you who you affiliated with, who jumped you in, who set you straight. You feel what I'm saying? So just think about this here. Imagine you going around falsifying that you a Christian. What if God was like Debo? Come on, man. What if God was like Debo? What if God was like, hey, home, I don't know you. You know what I'm saying? I don't know you. You feel what I'm saying? And it's going to be like that in heaven. I hate to tell you that, but that's just, I'm giving the logistics of how it's going to be. You're going to get right there to heaven gates. And God going to be like, I don't know you. And you're going to be like, God, what you mean? He's going to be like, well, you acting like you ain't know me. You act like you ain't know me. And then you ain't know my son either. You know what I'm saying? Go down the street. You know what I'm saying? No, I should have said street. That's what I should have said, street. Go down the street. You know what I'm saying? Not street, but the street. Go down the street, downstairs, and go down there with them that sage at. Go down there with, you know what I'm saying, with them crystals at. You know what I'm saying? That's who you knew. You know what I'm saying? That's who you knew. And you know the sad thing about it? The same ancestors that you were praying to are going to be standing up next to God. Oh, okay then. We're going to keep that at a two, though. Yeah, you're going to keep that at a two. All your ancestors that believed in God, that were praying out there on the plantation, that was praying. Now that this is what gets me. I ain't knocking nobody whatever they do, but this is my thing right here. I just think about logic. This is what I'm saying. You mean to tell me that I'm praying to the same ancestors? Now I'm denouncing believing in God and believing in Jesus. I'm denouncing believing in Jesus because they say there's a God and everything. But I'm denouncing that, and I'm gonna pray to some ancestors that was praying to my Jesus, that was praying to my God. So let me get this straight. So when I get to heaven, I'm going to take the chance of saying, I was praying to my cousin Tut. I was praying to my cousin Tut when Tut can't save me. Tut died and ain't come back for me. Okay then. Tut died and come on, I'm just saying though. When obviously, you say, John 3:16 say, for God so loved the world that he gave his begotten son, that who shall believe in him should not perish, but have everlasting life. Okay, you know what I'm saying? Tut didn't die for me. Okay, then. I'm just saying, though. And the sad thing about it is that to know that you were sent here to die. Now, ain't none of my relatives did that for me. Some of my relatives won't even fight for me, so... You mean to tell me that you're going to pray to some people that was praying to what you're supposed to believe in? Okay, then. I'm just saying, though. I'm not. You know, he said to walk in spirit and truth. I'm just saying to walk in spirit and truth. You know, I'm just keeping it all the way G. I'm just keeping it all the way G. Don't nobody want to believe what I'm saying. Just check the facts yourself. Read for yourself. One thing about me, I promise you, man, just read for yourself. That's all you got to do. You read for yourself and you'll realize that. Because, baby, I just, and that's the reason why when I tell you go date equally yoke, baby, date equally yoke. Do not date outside of what you believe in. You know what I'm saying? And like I say, any woman that say that she don't believe in Jesus, she don't need, I'm not for her. I'm not for her. And ain't nothing wrong with that. I'm not mad at her for that. Baby, glory, have a happy day. Because you get to a point to where you're not even mad at folks. You don't argue with folks. You know what I'm saying? You don't argue with folks. You don't get upset. You don't trip. You just let folks go on about their business. You let folks just go on about their business. And that's how you got to get. When you get so confident in yourself and you know exactly where you're going and what you're trying to do, you let folks go on about their business in peace. Because he told you, he said, peacemaker. He wants you to be a peacemaker. That was a good book say, be a peacemaker. And I'm telling you how you be a peacemaker. Leave. Because look, if you argue with a clown, big shout out to Kevin Gates. If you argue with a clown, you become part of the circus. I'm not here to be part of the circus. Come on now. I can't argue with a clown. I can't, you know what I'm saying? Because believe one thing, believe you me. If you want to know how close you are to God, let something listen. And this is my birthday, man. And I know I'm getting real deep tonight, but let me tell you something. But I just want you to know what's happening. I don't know about y'all, but I've been in some low places in life. You feel what I'm saying? Like, I've been in some low places in life. When I didn't have nothing, I needed prayer. I need to readjust my relationship with God. You feel what I'm saying? I don't know about, you know what I'm saying? Like, I just want to let y'all know something. I couldn't call on nobody else. Didn't nothing else make me feel better? You feel what I'm saying? I don't know about y'all. I don't know about y'all. I'm not trying to tell y'all what to do. You know what I'm saying? Matter of fact, let me turn my music. What's my jam right now? Okay, Google Play, Tone Next, Make Me Over. Man, let me tell y'all something. When I got on hard times, and I needed a word. I didn't need a word from my mama. I didn't need a word from my dad. I need to hear from God. And then what gets me is that all these people want you to stray away from God. They don't want you to believe in Jesus. But when they get on hard times and something goes wrong, they automatically send you to, they tell you, can you pray for me? I just don't understand. Why is it that you want me to pray for you now? Why do you want me to use my God in the name of Jesus when you fall on hard times? But when you were up and well, you want to make fun of my Jesus. You want to tell me about color and who he was and stuff like that, but that goes to show you don't read your Bible. That show that you didn't read your Bible. Let me tell you something. You have to get to a point to where you are one with yourself. You got to put God at the forefront, and you got to realize who you are and where you're going. You have to get to that point. Babe, let me tell you something. Today my birthday. Today has been a wonderful, great day. Everything's been good. But I know who I am. I know what I'm going for and what I ain't going for. I know what I need to work on. I know that about myself. But I know one thing. I know what I'm not. I'm not finna let you lead me to hell. Lord, forgive me, but I've been told you to go to hell before I go to hell. I'm just telling you what's real. Lord, forgive me. Lord, I'm just being honest with you. You know, I try to keep the podcast, you know, I try to keep it as profane, as free as possible. But I'm going to tell you something. I am not letting nobody lead me to hell. I've been the guy mad and told you to go before I let you lead me there. I'm just being honest with you. Because listen, it's a blessing to wake up. It's just a blessing to wake up. And for me to be able to celebrate 37 years, thank you for the happy birthdays. For me to wake up and see 37 years, it's a blessing. When I can tell you that 5 years ago, I didn't have nothing but $60 in a car full of clothes. Yeah, 5 years ago, I didn't have nothing. Yeah, I didn't have nothing. Like, I want you to feel me. No education. Now I got my bachelor's degree. No job. Now I have a career. Feel what I'm saying? I had lost my wife. You know what I'm saying? I lost my wife. Had lost touch of myself. I had lost who I was as a person. I had lost who I was. I had lost everything. Didn't have no money. Didn't have no direction. Didn't have nothing. And here 5 years later, I'm just showing you what God will do for you. I'm just telling you because he did it for me. And 5 years, I'm just showing you in 5 years. First of all, let's just not even get to five. I got here May 13th. I got in Dallas, Texas, May 13th of 2017. In December, I had started on, that was on my second job. Okay, making more money and everything. You know what I'm saying? I'm not going to get into how much I was making and stuff like that because that don't matter. That's irrelevant. But I was good. I was in a good position. And not only that, by the time I come back around, I had moved into my own apartment within 5 months. Come on, within 5 months of me being down here, I moved into my own apartment from having $6 in a car full of clothes. I was in a brand new car, standing, got my own apartment. Come on now, had my own apartment and was in school full time. Okay, I just want to let you know, it didn't take me 5 years to get to, come on now, my God works expediently. I'm talking about expeditiously. You feel what I'm saying? Like, shout out to T.I. You know, in 5 months, I was up. But I was faithful. I told God what I wanted and he gave it to me. I told God what I wanted and he gave it to me. And you know why he gave it to me? He didn't give it to me because of me. He gave it to me because he has to. Oh, I see y'all don't like y'all don't like that type of relationship with God. See, when you ask for something, he got to give it to you because you're a representation of him. I don't know how many people on here got children, but it's something about when your child is down and out. It's something within you that makes you want to do something for them. Okay, come on now. Yeah. It's like a child when they crying. You can try your best to ignore it all you want to, but eventually you're gonna pick that child up, and that's exactly how God looks at you. He can hear you howling. He can hear you crying. And no matter how much of a lesson he's trying to show you, at the same time, he got to pick you up. He said, I'm your comforter. He said, the Holy Spirit will be your comforter. That's what he said. He said, listen, he told him that. Let me tell you something. Let me get kind of comfortable. See, I'm going to go to old Baptist preachers on y'all today. This sober. I'm talking about that's why you can't get lit. Because somebody gonna get this here today. You feel what I'm saying? You're going to get that work. Let me tell you something. See, God came. Then all of a sudden, he sent Jesus. And then when Jesus showed himself for three times to the third and final time, and he went on to the heavens above, and the people looked up, he said, when shall we know your return? He said, it's not for man to know my time or season of my return, but I leave with you here a comforter. And that was the day of Pentecost. Come on now. And all the folks got to hollering and speaking in tongue and all that stuff. Listen, he left you a Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit is your comforter. That's why he told you to walk in spirit and in truth. Because when you got this Holy Spirit in you, man, you're going to walk with a truth. Because you're going to be led by the truth. See, you feel what I'm saying? Like when you got the Holy Spirit in you, you're going to walk with the truth. You're going to walk with the truth. Because you're going to have a conviction. Yeah. See, he said spirit and truth. Because see, let me tell you something. That's why the Bible tell you to test every spirit. That's the reason why the Bible tell you to test every spirit. Because every spirit ain't of God. That's why he said the Holy Spirit. Come on, man. Come on. He the Holy Spirit. The Holy Spirit. Holy Spirit dedicated to God. Holy. One. Dedicated to God. Okay. That's why he tell you to walk in spirit and truth. Because a demonic spirit can't walk in truth. Okay, then. Demons can't walk in truth. Okay, then. You know what I'm saying? They got to walk in deceit. I told y'all, man, today's show going to be something else. Because if I don't do nothing else, I want you to leave with something. I want you to leave with something. See, so let me tell you something. When people start talking about you, baby, it's time for them to go. Now, you a fool if you keep on listening. Now, you a fool if you keep on going getting that bad news. You a fool. Because the word gospel means what? Good news. So, good. All things work for the good. So, all gospel. Come on, man. I don't want to gossip. I want a gospel. Come on, man. I don't want to gossip. I want a gospel. Tell me something good. Answer your phone like that. Tell me something good. Just don't answer your phone like that. Tell me something good. And when you answer the phone like that, And as soon as they tell you some stuff like, I ain't got nothing good to tell you, but girl, let me tell you, hang up on them. Hang up on them. You don't have no more time to waste. You feel what I'm saying? You have no more time to waste. Baby, every single day that we let pass by and we don't do anything to make ourselves better, that was a day wasted. God has given you the ability to be healthy. God has given you the ability to speak, walk, everything. You got your health, you got your strength. But yet and still, we started talking about how we waiting on a blessing from God. What? You've been blessed with everything. If you wake up and you can move, you can talk, you can, you got the same opportunity as the billionaire. Appreciate the birthday shout out. Listen, Dr. Miles Monroe said, he said, it's the only difference between the billionaire and the beggar is the habits. See, I want you to break the habits that are causing you pain and start getting the habits that cause you pleasure. And let me show you what that means. I know people be like, oh, but dang that's what, nah, let me show you what I mean. Have you ever noticed, and I'm gonna bring this on. Don't let go of the habits that cause you pain. Let them go. And hold on to the ones that cause you pleasure. And I know a lot of y'all with y'all nasty mind. Your mind all the way went to the left. But let me show you something. You know, it's hard to get to the gym. But after you really know worked out, the feeling that you get knowing that you went in the gym and went hard is a feeling like no other. That's pleasure. Let me say it again. It's hard getting to the gym. Let me show you. It's hard getting to the gym. But when you know you done went to the gym and you get that sweat in, and you know what I'm saying, them that energy, you know what I'm saying, them dopamines, that's what I'm looking for. They kick in, you know what I'm saying, and you start feeling so good and refreshed. Guess what? You feel so refreshed. You feel the pleasure of knowing that you leaving that gym is like no other. Yeah. I'm gonna show you. I'm gonna show you that. I know exactly what I'm talking about here because I do a little studying myself. You got to let go of them things that hurt you and painful. Some of y'all on the phone with folks every single day that don't never tell you nothing good, that always hurting your feelings. You should be tired of that. You are too valuable as a person to hear that foolishness. I won't say I'm faulty, so you know I get to acting up in a minute. Before I close out, let me tell you something. Look, I want y'all to do this here for me. Do this if y'all don't do nothing else for me. This is my birthday wish. That just do this wish for me. You know what I'm saying? I want y'all to do this here for me. Create your life. Do that for me. Create your life the way you want it to be. Create your life the way you want it to be. And when you create your life the way you want it to be, start working on it today. And I know today Friday. Don't give me none of that. I'm going to wait till Monday. Start today. Start deleting numbers out your phone. Start throwing different foods out your house. Go to your cupboard and throw some of them sweets out. Come on, yeah. Stop buying things that you know you don't have no business eating. Start writing down your goals every single day. Come on, just write down. If you don't do number, write down 3 goals every single day. Do that. And then go to 5. Do this here for me. Appreciate the love, baby. Appreciate this love. Start working on yourself because God wants you to win. He wants you to win. He wants you to win. Start. Listen. I've already started this up, but when you go through your social media, be careful on what you're looking at. Don't listen. Be careful what you look at. Stop looking at things that pollute your mind. I'm just being honest with you. And I had to check myself. I'm not telling you that I don't know. I slowly started going through my Instagram. I got to the point where I was going through my Instagram and if all I see is a certain particular type of situation going on, I start deleting it. I mean, I start deleting it because it's polluting my mind. It's not making me better. I'm just being honest. I don't hang out with the people I used to hang out with. I don't hang out with the people I used to hang out with. You know why I don't? Because you got to value yourself. The Bible says that a man, he seeks wise counsel. I only deal with people now. I don't care about folks saying I'm acting funny. Yes, I am. Because when I was with you, wasn't nothing going right. So you got to get around some people that's going to encourage you. Some people that's going to lead you. And sometimes they're going to be tough on you, but it's out of love. Appreciate the love. Birthday love. Appreciate it. You got to get around some folks that went. Let me show you something. I don't know if y'all seen Dr. J. Harrison, Jamal Bryan. But let me show you what happened. He said that when you get hurt, you know what I'm saying? When you slam your hand in the door, the whole body jumps. You feel what I'm saying? If you not around people that when you hurt, they hurt, you need to let them go. They don't need to be that close to you if they don't feel your pain. If they don't feel your pain, they don't have no business being that close to you. Because if they that close to you and they can't feel what's going on with you, you need to let them go anyway, baby. Because they already gone. I'm just telling you what's real. He said that when the hand gets slammed in the door, the whole body jumps though. That's because what's ever connected to you should feel the same thing you feel. Yes, what's ever connected to you should feel everything you feel. I got the greatest compliment of the world today. And I'm being serious. I got the greatest compliment in the world. I had somebody tell me today. They said, Roy, I can just feel your joy. Yeah. They said, I could just feel. They said, I could just feel your joy. Let me tell you something. This is the best birthday I've ever had. This is the best birthday I've ever had in my life. And I done had some birthdays. From Vegas to other places, I done had some birthdays. You know what I'm saying? But don't none of that mean nothing to me. You know why? Because the greatest feeling in the world is to know why I was placed here. Let me tell you something. This is the greatest birthday I've ever had in my life. I'm 37 years old, and I can say with hands down, 10 toes down to the ground, look me dead in my eyes, and I can tell you this is the best birthday I've ever had. Because, man, I'm not faking on who I am. This is who I am. I know why I'm here. I know my purpose. I know what I'm supposed to be doing. I'm not seeking paper. I'm seeking purpose. I done chase money. I ain't had that. That come and go. That come and go. But purpose lasts forever. Purpose lasts forever. When you diligently seek your purpose, you be amazed how your life drastically changed. You jump up out the bed in the morning smiling. You go to bed. You can't even go to bed at night because you're anxious. And I know the Bible says you shouldn't be anxious for nothing, but it's just a glorious feeling to know that you have a purpose. You have a destination. I could sit around and chase money like it ain't nothing. I could chase money. I could sit over here by myself in my lonesome, give me some cryptocurrency, give me some real estate and all that. I'm going to do all that anyway, but all I'm going to be is just a rich, lonely person. That's it. But let me tell you something. It's some people right now. It's some people right now that got a whole lot more money than me. A whole lot more money than me. But they poor in the inside. And my cup runneth over with joy. My cup runneth over with joy. Anybody that talks to me, they just be like, you just have such a glow about yourself. It ain't me. It's the God in me. It's because I realize what God is what I'm here to do. I ain't trying to be like nobody else. I ain't trying to compete with nobody else. Listen, I don't watch other people's lives. I don't talk like nobody else. I don't act like nobody else. I'm me. And I ain't apologizing for being me. I'm not apologizing for being me. And I don't want you to apologize for being you. You don't have no business being sorry for the way God made you. But when you diligently seek God and find out who you are, you automatically going to run people off. Because what's going to happen is that when you begin to change, you gonna hurt some feelings. The reason why you hurt some feelings is because people expected you to stay who you was, and they don't want to accept who you going to be. They don't want that. They just don't want you to do that. They do not want you to become who you supposed to be. They want you to continue to stay in the place that you are. They want you to continue to complain about those horrible relationships. They want you to continue to complain about your job, complain about your relationship with your family. Baby, talk about it and get over with and let that go. Because the new you, you're going to talk about, I'm waiting on my future spouse. Okay then. Oh, I ain't tripping in my job because guess what I did is that I had a conversation with that coworker. And guess what? We best of friends now. If you want to stop negativity, the only way you can get rid of darkness is with light. And let me tell you something. Stop talking to people about negative things. Stop talking to them about negative things. Stop talking to people about negative things. Because what happens is that people feed off that. You could do an experiment. You could call somebody and just start saying something about something bad every day. Be like, oh my Lord Jesus, I have so many problems like this faucet. Every time I look at the faucet, you'll talk about that so much to where you'll be on the phone with them a couple days, a couple weeks later, and you'll be like, I'm finna wash my hands. And the first thing they'll say is, I know you ain't going to that faucet that give you so many problems. Why would you even bring that up? Because people feed off negativity. People feed off that. People feed off that. So, put a 100 in the comment if I taught y'all something tonight. Did I teach y'all something tonight? I'm just saying, though, did I teach y'all something tonight? So, if y'all don't get nothing else from tonight, I want y'all to do this. Do these three things for me. Create your life. Visualize and see yourself for who you gonna be. Write down your goals. Execute them. Create your life the way you want it to be. It's up to you, baby. It's up to you. I'm telling you right now, it's up to you. Don't nobody owe you nothing, baby. I don't want to hear no complaining. Don't nobody owe you nothing. You owe it to yourself. And you're gonna have to be hard on yourself. And you got to let these folks go. I don't care who it is, because you got to think about it. Are they bigger than God? All I'm saying is right now the doors of the church open. Let me stop playing. Y'all know it. Hey, y'all know it's 7:50. For the next 40 minutes, it's questions and answers. Whatever y'all want to ask me, and let's talk about my birthday. We got the teaching out the way. Now it's time for question and answer. Hey, remember one thing. If y'all ask me a question, I must reply. Yeah, ushers, take your place. That's how preachers do it. Glory. Then he tell them, shh, shh. Will there be one today? Will there be one to give their life to Christ? Will there be one today? For the Bible says that when you hear my voice, harden not your heart. Tomorrow's not promised to you. Will there be one today? Don't look at your neighbor. Don't look at your neighbor. Matter of fact, everybody close their eyes. Everybody close their eyes. Just know that tomorrow's not promised to you. I'll tell you what. You don't even have to come down here to me. I'll come to you. Will there be one today? By letter or by Christian experience, will there be one today? Don't worry about what people will say about you. Don't worry about it. Because God is waiting on you. He's never left your side, but he just wants you to embrace him. Will there be one today? Yet we have done if God has commanded it. If there will be not be one, will there will not be one, we have done as God has commanded. Amen. It's mine. What's something that you always wanted? And I'm guessing it was joy. God answered your prayers. Most certainly. Real talk though. Let me get my slow jam going back on. Let me get my slow jam back going. Okay, Google. Play 12 Play by R. Kelly. Usher, you may be seated. Cause we finna R&B this thing now. We finna R&B this thing. Sit down. Hey, as a preacher do. Sit down. But no, you're right. That's what I really truly wanted, man. I really truly, yeah, switch it on. Now it's on birthday. It's your birthday. Okay, then. Listen, man. Switch up gang strong. Real talk, though. Because you got to be diverse, man. You could be the same person who you're going to be, man. Your morals and stuff, you don't have to bend those. But I'm not no holier than thou person. But I'm very, very hard on myself. You know what I'm saying? But to answer the question, though, yes. I really and truly, I got to the point to where in life to where I understood exactly what it is that I wanted. But it took time. And when I did that, I just realized that money and all this other stuff, it didn't make me happy. All the women in the world didn't make me happy. The greatest job didn't make me happy. And then I just asked God for direction. He said, trust in the Lord in all things. I shall direct your path. That's real talk. And he did that. When I started speaking is the best thing in the world to me. I love it. I love it with all my heart and soul. Helping people, encouraging people, helping people through their problems, through words and through helping them to get through challenges. And it's the best thing ever in the world. And I feel like when God gives you something, it's not hard on you. It's not hard on you. GY, what's up, baby? Are you barbecuing this weekend? I don't know. I'm barbecuing Sunday. I'm gonna do a brisket this Sunday. I'm gonna do a brisket for myself this Sunday. I'm gonna go over that to my parents' house tomorrow night, and I'm gonna season the brisket up, and then I'm gonna put it on the grill and let it smoke all night. You know, put some of that hickory smoke wood chips on there. Then, you know, I'm put that brisket on the top shelf or the barbecue pit. And I'm going to cut up some onions, bell peppers, and a couple of apples and put it on top of the coal. So that simmering, so I can get that smell and that fragrance in there and get that seasoning up in there. You feel what I'm saying? And that's what we're going to do. I'm going to let it smoke all night. That thing going to fall off the bone. You know, I'm going to make a TikTok about it. You got to make y'all a little jealous. You know what I'm saying? It ain't going to be on direct heat. No, baby. Nietzsche Nicole, baby. No, baby. You don't put it on that. See, when you're a real barbecue master, see, you got the top shelf and you got the bottom shelf. See, the bottom shelf is where you directly put the heat on it. The top shelf is where you smoke it at. So I'm gonna put that brisket on the top, and I'm gonna let it smoke all night. I'm gonna let it smoke all so good. Yeah, you know what I'm saying? Like, I'm gonna let it smoke all night, and then when I get up the next morning, because I'm gonna spend the night at my mom's house. Because that's one thing about it, I don't never leave the meat. You feel what I'm saying? I'm stay over there to my mom's house. I'm wake up the next morning, then I'm put me a couple of sides together. You know what I'm saying? And then after that, we're gonna get the hamburger patties, you know, the usual chicken and stuff like that. Okay, my brother teaching me. He's 16 and loves to cook. Most certainly, Rosada, what's up with you, baby? Appreciate it. Happy birthday. Appreciate it, baby. That's just being honest, man. See, I'm a dog on that grill. I'm good in the kitchen. But I'm really good on that barbecue grill. I'm be honest with you. You know, I'm really good on that barbecue grill. You fixing to do it up? Most certainly, man. It's my birthday weekend. I know how to cook, but not barbecue. Yeah, it be like that sometimes. This is just me. I'm a Louisiana man, so you should have a live cooking session. I might do that. Appreciate it, baby. Thank you for the happy birthday love. Yeah, I might do that, man. I might really and truly get on live and walk through a whole cooking session with me. I'm not that independent to grill. Hey, man, I'm a Louisiana man. Like, I'm a real Louisiana dude. I love it, and I just cook. I really do. I get on the grill, and I feel like when the sun out, the barbecue pit got to be out, especially on the weekend. I'm a cook, and I felt disrespected. It's real, real talk, though, man. I love cook. I love barbecuing, man. It's just something about it. I don't know what it is. It's just like a man's thing that I love to do. I feel like every man should be able to barbecue. He might not be good in the kitchen, but he got to at least know how to barbecue. You got to be able to barbecue. I'll leave that to the men. And that's real. I'll do it, but that fire's a devil, most certainly. Have you read the books on Atomic Habits? Most certainly. That's in my Audible book. Atomic Habits is great. That's what kind of made me a better person. Habits, man. Habits make you who you are. And we don't lose habits. We just replace them. You feel what I'm saying? Like, we just replace them. And that's it, man. So, like, for instance, I'm going to show you something about me. I'm going to share something with you. All right. What made me start going to the gym I started putting myself on a schedule, and I stuck to it. And at first, it was kind of hard. I ain't gonna lie to you. But then all of a sudden, when I didn't go to the gym, I started missing it. I started feeling guilty, because whenever you, anything is an addiction. Now don't get it twisted. Whatever you, it's like when you not like you do. There's love, forgive me for saying like this. But if you do a certain thing for so long, and you stop doing it, your body gets so used to it, you start yearning for it. That's why I tell people about relationships. Be careful if you really like somebody or you just used to somebody. Because you really don't like them and you really don't miss them. You just was used to them. You feel what I'm saying? So that don't mean that you really like them. You just was used to them. You were used to them calling. You were used to them coming by. You were used to them feeling on you. And that's the thing. But that don't mean that you really like them. You feel what I'm saying? Because if you give yourself enough time, you can forget about them. So that's just what it is. Yeah. So you got to put yourself on a routine. And I know people love to say, I don't like to be routine. Sometimes you need routine to get yourself some structure in your life. It's not the fact that a lot of people aren't good, great people or not good. They just have no structure. And that's just being real. You know what I'm saying? Once you get some structure and you be like, I'm just dedicated to doing this, this is what it is. I'm down 15 pounds. Like, and I lost that weight real quick at first, and then now it's more like now I'm building muscle, but it's all with consistency. I stopped looking at the scale and I started looking at how I look. You feel what I'm saying? And that's just what it is. I know when I start back, I'll be there every day. That's what's up. Anything you do with 20, you're right. It just Cajun love, scrape it all off. That's it. Man, yeah, and then when it comes to that, let me talk about this barbecue fire. The fire. It's not hard either. Let me show you why it's not hard. Appreciate it, Rosada. Thank you, baby. The fire's not a problem either. What you got to do, what's the benefit of the stuff you take? What's the benefits of the stuff you take? What stuff what you mean, what do I take? But let me show you about this fire real quick. When you put that coal in there, it depends on the size of your grill. My grill like that big. It's a real small grill I use in my parents' house. I don't use a whole lot of coal. It depends on what kind of food I got. So, there go the curls. What I do is I can put them in almost like a teepee, in a teepee, right? But the catch is this here. I light the fire because I do matchless. I don't do no lighter fluid or nothing like that. So what you do is that you light the top. When you light the top, you're supposed to get all the way down, right? And then once it starts turning white. But what I do is that I get a piece of paper or something and I make sure the sides of it get lit also. I light the fire and then I light the piece of paper and I throw it on each side of it so I can make sure the coal in the bottom of it is still going. So therefore I let it burns for like 15 to 20 minutes and then you spread them out. And once you spread them out, that's when I have my bell peppers, my onions. You know what I'm saying? Don't have too many onions. Just have your bell peppers and your onions. And I cut up a couple of apples and things like that. Sometimes oranges. It just depends on how I'm feeling. Feeling how exotic I'm feeling. And I put them on there with the wood chips. And you're going to automatically see some smoke. And you know what I'm saying? Now, that's why I tell you about that. Don't have too many onions. Because when you put it in the grill, and then the aroma start hitting you, you'll start getting teary-eyed. But you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? And listen, you can't do it like that. That's why you put it on that, and you just let that smoke for a little. Just smoke, smoke, smoke. And it's going to smell absolutely wonderful. By that time, you go in the house, man. You season it up real good. You know what I'm saying? It's good Louisiana season on that brisket. Rub it down, and you got, you know what I'm saying? Just like you be looking at, just like y'all be looking at the masseuse, them dudes that be doing massages and stuff on social media. That's how I do that brisket. I'm talking about rub it real down. That seasoning on that real good. I'm talking about slapping on, feeling on it. You know what I'm talking about? I'm talking about feeling on it. You know what I'm talking about? Feeling on it like it ain't nothing. You know what I'm saying? Y'all feel on it all the way around, man. Y'all gonna make me knock my microphone down. I'm telling y'all. You know what I'm saying? You gotta get it all the way on there. You know what I'm saying? Then you smother it down real good, and then boom, put that brisket on there and let it just smoke. Just let it smoke overnight, 12, 14 hours. Just let it smoke. Man, you get that brisket, man. That brisket be falling off the bone. You know what I'm saying? I'm trying, because that's what they be. You know, that's how the massages be. If y'all looked at the massage, them erotic. Let me tell you something. Let me get that clear. Let's talk about this here. Any woman that I'm dealing with, if she do not want to be single, don't ask me to be getting one of them massages. Don't ask me. Don't listen. Let me tell you something. Let me explain something to you. Once you become my old lady, you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? Listen, let me tell you something. Once you become my old lady, don't ask me to get no massage like that from no man. I don't even want a woman touching you like that. And then to the extent of what y'all gotta get down to. Like, I seen a video today, a woman just in a thong. Let me tell you something, baby. Whoever done seen you in that thong before me, I can't change that. But it'll be a cold day in H-E double hockey stick before another man see you like that, and you don't be single before the end of the evening. You'll be over with. It's over with. It's over with, kid. Over with, kid. I don't want to call me insecure. Call me anything. I don't care. I just told y'all about peace, didn't it? I'm going to be peaceful. I'm going to have my peace. Man, y'all be sitting away that man. Man. And I know I got big hands. I know I be looking like, why he got to make all them faces? Why he got to, listen, if this is professional, why he making so many faces? He be... What you mean? I'm talking about, man, listen, I know I got strong hands. I know I got big hands. I got big, strong hands. I be looking at, man, listen. That man, don't people be, I'm talking about, then he had a woman, let me put his microphone. He had a woman booty way up here. I kill him. In discussion, I kill him. I walk in, I see you hiked up in the air like that. I'm killing everybody with my bare hands, no shooting. I'm gonna choke him. I'm gonna choke him. I'm have to. You know what I'm saying? He done felt on you like that. Listen, man, that man just made love to you. Listen, that man ain't making love to you. I'm talking about he be so serious, man. I'm talking about, listen. Come on, cuz. Listen. It ain't for me. Call me insecure, call me whatever. It ain't finna happen. Next question, please. I went with my man doing the same. You know what I'm saying? First of all, I'm coming home. It's called a deep tissue massage. See, you done got felt on. See, I see right now, you done got felt on. I see that. Wait, what did I come back to? I'm talking about the massages. Don't watch the ones on Twitter. Oh, man, they disrespectful. Anybody else jealous that was your... Man, I'm telling you, man. I'm just, man. Come on, man. Don't worry. I won't get whatever, sir. Whatever the massage is, gay. Let me... Do y'all really want... You want me to get... G-Will. You want me to have a conversation with you? Look at Destiny talking about she need one. Bet you can't do it. Let me tell you something. Let me explain something to you. I don't believe no man is 110% gay. I don't believe that. That's just my personal opinion. I don't believe no man is 110% gay. I don't believe that. Real talk, though. I'm not saying that a man cannot be gay. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? But I don't believe no man is 110% gay. I don't believe that. That's just me. That's just being honest. I don't believe that. I don't believe no man is 110% gay. Because I done heard, at least I got gay cousins. And my gay cousins will tell you, if they see women that's fine enough, they'll be like, they better be lucky I got a boyfriend. You know what I'm saying? So I don't believe that. My husband can give me a massage, but nobody, I respect that. That's real. Press on me. Oh, okay. Okay. But you think somewhere in them, he will have some feelings for a woman? Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah. Because women are so beautiful. This is the reason why I'm saying that. Women are so beautiful. I want y'all to feel what I'm saying. Women are so beautiful to where, no matter how much a man may, you know, I'm not saying that he doesn't prefer the opposite sex and things like that, but you know what I'm saying? Women are so beautiful to where you will have men that even though they have basically identified as being gay, they really and truly still will go there with a woman. So I have a gay friend that you know about. We can cuddle when you're not around. Man, let me tell you something. I tell y'all what. If y'all think y'all friend, I tell you what, if you think that your friend's so gay, pay attention to their demeanor when you know what I'm saying, when you in your most feminine form, like when you get in certain scenarios, like getting undressed and stuff like that. Like, just, you know what I'm saying, just pay attention. Like, I'm telling you, man, no man is 110% gay. I don't care how feminine he act or none of that, because they're going to make comments. I'm telling, they're going to make comments. And that's that to go to show you. I'm just being honest with you. I got gay cousins that will fight for me before anything else. Just being honest with you. But, man, listen, you cuddle with him, you gonna feel some pokage. Talk to me. You not lying, because I have a gay friend, and he definitely be looking. I'm telling you, man, that no man is 100. Man, men are sexual beings. Like, we sexual, man. Like, we really and truly are sexual. Cause we really, you know what I'm saying? You want some pokage. Yeah, you want some pokage. You going to be, oh, hold on, player. Yeah, nah, he need to go cuddle with his man. Get away from me. Yeah, come on, man. Stand up. Yeah, not the cross. Come on, man. Yeah. Get some pokage. Oh, Lord. Yeah, like. Yeah, that's what it is. That's what it is. Yeah, you're gonna feel some pokers. That's what I'm saying. I don't believe that. I don't believe that 110%. But I can show you why. I was talking about it earlier with a friend of mine. And she made perfectly good sense. Like, people that think about this, just do this math with me. I just want you to check this out. You have definitely thought my good friend was gay until I came out of bikini. And that, okay, then. Then he talking about he bi. Okay. 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 All right. Talk to me. All right. Yeah. Let me tell you something. Yeah. Think about this here. Think about the people that go through a transition. They change genders. They turn from a man to a woman. And go date a woman. Then it turned into a man. Think about it now. And think about how. Come on, I'm just saying. I've never heard of pokage before. You done heard of some pokage. If you ain't heard of it, you done experienced it. Dead ear. Talk to me now. But check this out, though. Okay, what I'm saying is, just notice that. And then on top of that, let's do the math on here. Help make it make sense. I'm just showing, though. Like, if you look at two men, you know what I'm saying? You look at two men, look what they do in the bedroom. They have to, they ain't a change, like, what they doing. So, you know what I'm saying? So, they still doing some poking. Like, I don't know. Listen, kid. And what you got, way better than what they get. So, hey. The math ain't math. And they just all kinds of. I'm just telling you what's real. Like, it's just life. That's just what we at in life. You know what I'm saying? One thing about me, man. I just learned the psychology of things. So, I don't look at things as if it's strange. I just look at it just not my thing. You feel what I'm saying? Because when you look at the psychology of things, you be like, you know what? That's just not my thing, but it's somebody for that. There's a place for that. So, you feel what I'm saying? Because the world that we live in, man, our freedom has become an imprisonment. Like, we pimp our own mind. We fool ourselves to believe, you know what I'm saying, certain things. You feel what I'm saying? Our freedom is an imprisonment. Like, we have imprisoned ourselves to think that anything is okay. It's a thing, just not my, yeah. You know what I'm saying? Do your thing. Like, I got cousins right now. You would never think. I got cousins right now. Walk in the room, and you think they the most gangster people in the world. And man, and yeah. And you think they looking at you, they wondering if they could wear that sundress. Yeah, like that. He ain't say nothing. He said poke. Yeah, he feels some pokish. Yeah. Did you enjoy your birthday today? Man, look at it. I enjoyed it to the fullest, man. I'm blessed. I'm blessed. When I tell y'all I'm blessed. Man, y'all can see it on my face. Man, y'all can see it all the way through me. Man, I got my favorite color on. You know, red, my favorite color. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Like, man, life is great on my end. And I'm still eating healthy. I ate healthy all day today. Stay focused, you know what I'm saying? Because I know I'm back up this weekend. So, I just stay focused today. That's it. Happy born day. Appreciate it. Happy birthday. Appreciate it. Is the half for me? Yeah, yeah. See what it sounded. Yeah, yeah. We say what? Yeah, yeah. I know. I love red. It looks good. Appreciate it. It looks amazing. Appreciate it. Are you still meal prepping? Most certainly. I went to the store last night just to meal prep. Oh yeah, I'm gonna be ready for the summer. Six pack gonna be on point. By my June, July, six pack gonna be unreal, man. We do need the Hat Connect. Man, you know that's some top G14. You know what I'm saying? I'm just saying that's some G14 classified information. Now please tell me you saw Paula's Chicken though. What's Paula's Chicken? I ain't never seen that. What is that? Laugh out loud, the hat. Yeah, you know what it is. He ain't giving up the Hat Connects. Happy birthday, King. Appreciate it, baby. Appreciate it. You know, when she say happy birthday, King, that means she's saying happy birthday, Roy. Because you know what my name stands for in French. It stands for Roy. What did you buy from the grocery store to prep? Ground turkey, spinach. That's all I got last night. But, you know, I'm going to switch it up next week. I kept it real simple. Right, I need it. I'm going to tell it. I got like five hats from them. Oh, that's what you doing. That's what you doing, Meek. That's what you want to do. I'm gonna tell what you did for my birthday. Yeah, I'm put your business on the street. You put that hat business out there, I'm gonna put your business out there in the street. Is that what you want to do? All right, I know where to get the hat from. My brother wears them, and that's good for you. Lord, somebody send them Paula's Chicken. Send them Paula's Chicken. What is that? Shout of love. I got a photo shoot. You know, dog, where? Oh, you right. So the hat gonna be the only thing you gonna have on in the photo shoot. You know how y'all get down in the photo shoot. I just talked about it. You know what I'm saying? I'm not ashamed. I don't want you to be ashamed. I just don't put people in your business. Don't put nobody in my business. You feel what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? All right. You know what I'm saying? Blessings on top of blessings. Yeah. Appreciate it, baby. Thank you. Yeah. Now, Meek, I just want to let. I got a big shout out to Meek. Meek really looked out for me for my birthday, man. I can just tell you one thing, man. Meek been a real, real, real supporter of the team. And I can tell you one thing, man. She has really been a supporter of Chosen Not Taken, man. And it does not go unoverlooked or anything like that. It's a blessing, man. I'm talking about surprise me out the world, man, you know. And you let me clear the air. It felt good to have somebody do something for me. And they didn't ask for my phone number. Didn't try to holler at me. Didn't try to shoot their shot. You know what I'm saying? Just really and truly just wanted to do something for me. Yeah, read my question, please, honey. I ain't see your question, baby. Say it again. You know what I'm saying? Yeah, the homie. You know what I'm saying? Real tight. They just felt really good, man. You know, Paula, the actress, you should have seen the way she made the chicken. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, I miss it. None of that. Most certainly. And I swear to God, on everything I love, man, I love that. Because, man, you know, genuine organic people are very, very rare in today's time. You know what I'm saying? Happy birthday, enjoy your day. Appreciate it. Thank you so much. Man, like it's so hard to run across what part of Louisiana. If I'm from Shreveport, Louisiana, Cedar Grove, Louisiana. Man, it's so hard to find genuine people, man. It just feel good. And you know, and especially here on this platform, I try to make sure that I'm somebody that really and truly be genuine, organic. I try to teach. I try to make sure I give people some gems that they can take with them. You feel what I'm saying? And when you run across good organic people that do something for you, I don't ask for nothing. You know what I'm saying? My social media is not, listen, I'm just telling you, I'm not getting rich out of no social media. I'm being honest with you. If you know that, I'm not getting rich out of no social media. So I do this because I love doing this. I love helping people. And you know, the Bible says that your gift will make room for you. It's for real. And you know what I'm saying? And I can tell you one thing. I fell in love with each and every one of my followers today. And I fell in love with everybody that really truly looked out for me. It don't matter if it was $1 or $10. It don't make a difference what it is. Even if they ain't do nothing but say happy birthday. Every time somebody say happy birthday to me, I'm appreciative of it. And I love y'all for that. And I mean that because we live in a world with so many fake people. It just feel good to have somebody do something for you. Because people don't have to do nothing for you. And let me get that cleared up. Let me say it again. People don't have to do nothing for you. Let me say it again. You feel what I'm saying? People don't have to do nothing for you. So if you got anybody to take time out their day to do anything for you, if I wouldn't have got nothing but $1 today and I would have got 1,000 happy birthdays, I still was going to be here today turned up to the fullest because I'm blessed to get those 1,000 happy birthdays. I'm just appreciative. In all things, give thanks. I cannot thank y'all enough because y'all made my little heart go pitter-patter. Yeah, had my little feelings in them, had me in my little feelings today, man, because I was blessed, man. Appreciate the love. I appreciate y'all, man. I love y'all so much. And I'm going to let y'all know, man, my DM is open to y'all. I'm here to help y'all solve problems. I'm here to help y'all with confidence. I'm here for y'all, man. Real talk, though. I'm here for y'all. Like, I'm not. Don't lose out on a good resource. And I'm here for y'all for that. You feel what I'm saying? Exactly. You get on here 5 days a week and don't have to. Real talk, though. And y'all don't have to come listen. I'm gonna do that regardless. But y'all don't have to come listen. Real talk, though. Y'all don't have to. You know what I'm saying? Y'all don't have to. Y'all could be doing something else. Happy birthday. Appreciate the love. Seriously, thank you for the confidence, coach, you give. You let the Lord use you for real. I appreciate that, baby. Don't have me in my little feelings. Don't have me in my little feelings. Happy born day. That what's up, man. Well, it's 8:15. And I just got a couple questions for y'all. You've been a blessed child. I appreciate that. I done did a little teaching. I've been a little bit on the mature side, but I just believe that since this is the first day of me knowing y'all being 37 years old, I got to go back a little bit to, a little bit. Let's talk about a couple questions. I just want to know. I just got a couple questions. Can I ask y'all a couple questions? I just want to know. Can I ask y'all a couple questions? I appreciate the love. Appreciate that. I'm just asking. Can I ask a couple questions? I just want to add a couple questions. For the last couple days, we've talked about curls. We've talked about a lot of different things. I just want to know. Okay. I just got a couple questions. I don't mean no harm now. I know. I'm going to go over the time. I'm just letting you know that. I'm going my 8:30 tonight. I'm just being honest with you. I know I'm going over. I just have a couple questions. Let me not say a question. I have a statement, because I need to be your friend. I'm gonna be that friend. I'm gonna be that friend that you really need, baby. I don't know who need to hear this, but if your breast are extremely long, put a bra on. I don't know who need to hear this, but if your breasts are extremely long, or if they separated like the Red Sea, put a bra on. Certain shirts are not for you. I don't know who need to hear this, but God told me to tell somebody today. Hold on one sec. Okay, Google, play "This Is the Season" by William Murphy. I don't know who needs to hear this, but let me reiterate what I was saying. I was saying that if your breasts are extremely long, God told me to tell somebody today that if your breasts are extremely long, in the name of Jesus, put a bra on. God told me that if your breasts are separated and spread open like the Red Sea, some shirts are not for you. That's what God told me. Shh. Calm it down a little bit. God told me to tell somebody. Yeah, I brought one today. That's why I won't forget it. God told me to tell somebody. You know, they get to fixing that cloth right there. They get to fixing the cloth. God told me to tell somebody that every bodysuit does not suit you. God told me to tell somebody that today. Can I get a hallelujah in the comments? I'm not going to tell you to put hallelujah, because a lot of y'all can't spell. Somebody just put amen, because I know somebody can't spell hallelujah. Somebody told me right now to learn every word that you speak in the name of Jesus. Oh, Lord, glory. We got some spellers in the house. Glory. Hallelujah. We got some spellers in the house. God told me to tell somebody today that if you do put a bra on and you itching, go to the bathroom and scratch it. Go to the bathroom and scratch it. Because we are tired of you walking around doing this here all day long. We tired of that. God told me to tell somebody that today. Stop scratching this little part right here. Because we're going to think you got a rash in the name of Jesus. Glory. God told me to tell somebody today. God told me, I'm listening to him speak to me right now. God told me that I already told you about the body. God, you already said the body. So what you want? Okay. God told me to tell somebody today that see-through is not for you. Cover up in the name of Jesus. God told me that. God said, you steady putting on see-through and ain't nobody trying to see you. Glory. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. That's how they throw them down. They throw it down like that. They throw it down like that. You know, God told me to tell you that. I can't even be serious, man. I'm serious though, man. Listen, I love y'all, man. I love y'all to the fullest, man. But listen, get you some real friends that's gonna tell you not to do that. You done wiped off all your comics. Who trying to make jokes? Is you trying to make jokes? Is that what you doing? You trying to make jokey jokes? You are in due season for a TV show. Most certainly, I claim that in the name of Jesus. But y'all know I ain't lying, though. Tell the truth, though, man. I'm just being honest. Y'all know people be... Listen, I'm going to be honest with you. Just because you see somebody else wear it, that don't mean it's for you. I see some women... And listen, let me tell y'all fine ones something. Let's get it cleared up for all y'all fine ones. Y'all stop letting y'all friends... And I know some fine ones in here. You know what I'm saying? Let me tell you, I know some fine ones out there. That's on this live right now. Some fine ones. Y'all stop modeling these clothes and giving these folks that don't have no business wearing it hope. You hear me? You hear me? Y'all stop doing that. You feel what I'm saying? I'm just telling you what's real. I'm telling you because y'all selling false dreams just because they come in your side on me. That's real. Y'all stop doing it. I'm just telling you what's real. Y'all stop that. It's a reason why they go get the best looking friend the model they boutique clothes. Hello, talk to me somebody. No, don't go get the outfit. Go get the body. And if that ain't for you, that ain't for you. I'm just telling you what's real. Be modest. What you mean? Listen. Let me explain something to you. I love all women. Big, little, fit, thick, all that. I love all women. I think all women are beautiful in their own way. But my problem sets in when this happens. When you not playing to your strengths. Man, I'm 5'9", 237 pounds today. You know what I'm saying? You know, doing things, but... I'm 237. I don't wear stuff tight around my stomach and stuff like that. And my stomach ain't even out of control. But I don't wear that. That's not my strong point. My strong point are shoulders and arms. That's, you know what I'm saying? That's my strong point. You know what I'm saying? My shoulders and arms going. That's my strong point. I don't have a six pack. My stomach ain't big. You feel what I'm saying? But I ain't got a six pack. You let the boys with the six pack, let them wear what they wear. You feel what I'm saying? You let them wear. You feel what I'm saying? You let them wear what they want. I don't try to... Listen, what I'm saying is this here, baby. If you know that's not your... Wear your strong suit, baby. That's all I'm saying. Don't see your friend that's built like a brick house. I'm talking about fine as fine can be. You know what I'm saying? Like, I'm talking about fine and fine can be. You feel what I'm saying? And you try to dress like her. That's not your strong suit. It's not that. Hey, I'm just telling you what God love. You feel what I'm saying? Listen, you got to do what God tells. Listen, have a conversation with God about it. That's what I tell you. Next time you get dressed, ask God about it. Always. Have a conversation with God about it. Have a conversation with God about it. I'm a big woman, wear something conservative. Let me tell you something. Beautiful, voluptuous woman. Baby, it ain't nothing. Listen, I'm not telling you not to be fine. I'm not telling you that. But as a big woman, you got to stay in big. Listen, let me tell you something. I'm just keeping it all the way G. And I know I might have some people that don't like what I'm about to say. It's nothing better than a big woman. Nothing. Yeah, like I said, yeah. I like my women BBW. You feel me? You dig? You know what I'm saying? I'm just being honest. It's nothing. But my thing is that you don't have to. You listen. You can just be you. You don't have to dress like the other women. Like, be you, baby. Make what you do sexy. Make what you do fine. You ain't got to dress like the rest of them. Like, don't do that. Because they can't do what you do. They can't do what you do. You can't do what they do, and they can't do what you do. So, I don't understand it. But I tell you one thing. I might not have a six-pack, but I tell you one thing. Give me a cut-off t-shirt. Got to run for your money, Jack. Okay, let's get some of these shelled shoulders and these delts. Big back, you know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? Big back, you know what I'm saying? Big strong back, you know what I'm talking about? I'm going to do me. You feel what I'm saying? I'm going to do me. And that's why I say confidence. You don't have to dress like none. Embrace it. Yeah, big strong back. Yeah, gorilla, silver back. Walk on my knuckles. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying? Period. Let's rephrase that all women stay. Hold on. Say, stay what? What is that? Rephrase what? Let me see that. Women stay in your lane. You don't have to do anything another woman. Yeah. No, I'm telling you that. Because let me tell you something. I done seen some beautiful, beautiful, voluptuous women look good in a one piece. Look good. Scrum the young delicious. I'll bite on you. Better watch out. I'm might bite on you. You feel what I'm saying? And even with a two-piece, just do you. Don't never get caught up in the rat race. And I think that's what happens with a lot of women in today's time. Men too. Don't get caught up in the rat race. You ain't gotta do that. You ain't gotta do that. Just do you. You know what I'm saying? Like, just do you. Don't listen. Listen, let me tell you something, player. Don't do nothing because of other people. You know what I'm saying? Don't do nothing because other people. Because, baby, let me tell you something. You're a beautiful, voluptuous woman. You ain't hurting for nothing. Because I promise to God, it ain't a woman, it ain't a BBW on here that's under God truth that they DM is not full. Hello, talk to me, somebody. Hello, talk to me, somebody. Yeah. Because I'm a real man. I know. Come on, man. I'm a real man. I'm a real man. I'm going to keep it 100 with you. That's why I tell y'all the real, man. I listen. I love all women. I don't know who I'm going to be with. You feel what I'm saying? I don't know who I'm going to be with. But whoever I'm going to be with, I'm going to be with them. I'm going to be with them. Because I'm going to do what I want. It don't make no difference if she threesome. She going to be my threesome. It don't matter if she 120. She going to be my 120. You know what I'm saying? Tell you that right now. Yeah, that's just, yeah, she three something, it's on. I'm going there, I'm going to wrestle with her. Yeah, come here, baby. We're going to wrestle. You know what I'm saying? I don't know. I'm talking about coming there wide open. Come here. What you want to do tonight? Yeah, what you want to do? You know what I'm saying? I'm going to wrestle. Yeah. Come here. I got you tonight. Come here. Yeah, that's what I'm going to do. She 120, I'm going to be like, well, come here, baby. Just come here, baby. You know what I'm saying? I'm not degrading no woman. I'm just telling you, baby, to stay in your lane. Don't look at these other women and try to compare, because they don't compare to you. You know what I'm saying? I'm just being honest with you. They don't compare to you. Because, baby, they can't do what you do, and you can't do what they do. You just got to do you. Yeah. You just being real. And that's just being 100 with you. Now with the God, yes, the gospel, the truth. Yeah, I got the truth in the background. You got the butter for the, man, let me tell you something, baby. I'm going to get in the shower with her, wash all them crevices for her. Yeah, like that, grown man style. Yeah. Come on, man. Yeah, wash all the cribs. Come here, girl. Come here. Yeah, with that little scoofy, whatever it is y'all be bringing. Y'all know y'all be having that little scoofy thing. That be on y'all cheap pack. You know, that's the cheap pack. Y'all know when y'all come over to a house and y'all spend the night, man, y'all had y'all little overnight bag, and then y'all had a little body wash, had y'all own soap, and then y'all had, you know what I'm saying, one pair of underwear, and you know what I'm saying, and y'all probably wear his shirt. Yeah, you know what y'all be doing. Yeah, a little bit. Yeah, I know a little song. Y'all come over there in this house, come on, yeah, like that though. The little thing, then, you know what I'm saying, because the only thing you ask for is a drive tie. Yeah, you only ask for no, you don't need no face tie, I don't none of that. Yeah, let me get that little loofah. Yes, it, loofah. Yeah, get the little loofah. Yeah, scrub it up real good. Yeah, like that. Yeah, I know exactly what y'all coming over. Man, let me tell y'all something, man. Appreciate the love. Appreciate the birthday love. Let me tell you something. I know about all that. Yeah, can't tell me nothing about it. Yeah, I know about all that. Yeah. When y'all come over, let me tell you, when a woman come over your house, man, you already know what the play is. She already know she going to, yeah, get down with you. So, yeah, what she going to do? She going to come over the bag. Yeah. She gonna come up with the bag. When she come with the bag, that what she gonna have? She gonna have a little loafy, a little loofah in there. She gonna have that. She gonna have a little case. She gonna have a little case with the, you know what I'm saying, with the soap in it. You know what I'm saying? She might bring her own little body wash. That depends. You know what I'm saying? Depends on if she really trying to get right. You feel what I'm saying? Yeah, that's what she doing, kid. She already know the play here. Yeah, that's the overnight. I'm leaving the bag in the car. Yeah, you gonna fake it real good. Yeah, but the reality of it is, you know what it is. You leave the bag in the car because you ain't for show. But when she, look here, when she for real, all she gonna do is get up the next morning, or she gonna get up the next morning, because see, she not already, you know what I'm saying, got right before she came and seen you. You know what I'm saying? She not already got right before she came and seen you, you know what I'm saying? So when she get to the door, she already in her, you know, getting felt on starter kit, you know what I'm saying? She got the Ugg boots on, slippers, she got the tights on, the leggings or whatever, you know what I'm saying? And probably a pullover. You know what I'm saying? Pull over. Then got the hair already in the ponytail or something like that. Duh. She ready for war. She coming in ready for war. She with the yeah to the yeah. So, you know what I'm saying? She going to hit the door. She like, you know, act like she just want to kick it or whatever. Then she going to let you get a little drink in you or whatever. You know what I'm saying? And she going to act like she wasn't trying to do nothing. But she had already told her homegirl that he was going to get it tonight. You know what I'm saying? So, after you get through feeling on and stuff like that, y'all lay down or whatever, go to sleep. Then she going, you know, this is what women with good hygiene do. She get up in the middle of the night. She be like, I got to take a shower. Oh, okay then. And get what she going to do. You know what I'm saying? She gonna go to the bathroom and she gonna be like, she gonna look out the bathroom. You know what I'm saying? She gotta tease you a little bit because she gonna get all her clothes just to look out the door and say, where your big tiles at? Like, where your drive tiles at? Oh, okay then. Oh, okay. And you be like, oh, I got one right here. You know what I'm saying? Because when you're the man house, he already got his drive tiles right. You feel what I'm saying? Because he got company. You gonna have his drive tiles, everything right there in the closet. You know, everything together when she get there. You know what I'm saying? If you're dealing with a real man. You know what I'm saying? Little boy, he ain't gonna be like that. But a real man, he gonna have it all already good. Bathroom gonna be clean and everything. He done hit the bathroom with the bleach, comment, you know what I'm saying? Sprayed it down with Tylee, everything. He done washed it down and scrubbed down. Cause he already know. Cause if you feel on, he know she gonna wanna take a bath. You know what I'm saying? Not a bath, but a bath. You know what I'm saying? Bath. You know what I'm saying? I'm just telling you what's real. You know what I'm saying? That's just what it is. Pine saw, yeah. You know what I'm saying? To put the bleach in, you know what I'm saying? To put the Clorox in the toilet and everything. And wiped on the bottom of the toilet, wiped all the way around, and the mopped and swept and everything before she got the candles lit. Come on now. Yeah, got them candles lit. Yeah. Got the candles lit like that though. Yeah, like that though. She come in, she gonna be like, oh, your house smells so good. Yeah, little son, you like that? Yeah, like that though. Yeah, that's all what it is. Dove sensitive skin, most certainly. Yeah. Yeah, the one with the pink on now. Yeah, the white ball with the pink and white box. Yeah, the box with the pink on it. It's either gonna be that one or it's gonna be the one with the blue letters on there. Hello, talk to me somebody. Yeah, listen. I know a little song, that's it. You know what I'm saying? I ain't always, I always been saved, sanctified. Yes, the blue. I knew it one up. Yeah, I know. Come on. Yeah, but it's the blue one. See that? You know what I know. You know, I know what's happening. Appreciate the love, baby. Appreciate the love. Yeah. I know what's happening. Yeah, I don't do no faking. Yeah, I know what's going on. Yeah, I know what's going on. Yeah. You know too much. Nah, I know enough. More men need to pay attention to women. You feel what I'm saying? Listen, and the only reason why I got like this is because I started listening to women. See, I'm not, pardon my French, I'm not sex crazy. Like, I'm not sex crazy. You feel what I'm saying? I'm not sex crazy. So when you get away from, as a man, as he matures as a man, and he stops being sex crazy, he starts to listen to women and pay attention to women. You know what I'm saying? He start paying attention to women. You know what I'm saying? And when you start paying attention to women, you start understanding that good women have different habits than bad women. I'm just telling you what's real. You paying too much attention. I pay attention to everything. Listen, first of all, I ain't always been the most, you know what I'm saying, the best man in the world. So, first of all, whenever women used to come over to my house back in the day, I used to always have to be real paranoid. I was, you know, this is what it is. I wasn't used to women coming to my house. But then when I changed my life for the better, when women come over to my house, I still have those ways. So, I started paying attention to things of my women. You know what I'm saying? Well, what's up, Key? What the business is? So, what happens is that I start paying attention to women. When I start paying attention to women, it's amazing how my dialogue changed with women. My dialogue changed. I started talking to women. Like, we just have open conversation now. So, I talk to women. Like, we have real conversation. I know you fine. I know I want to feel on you. That's okay. Whoop-de-doo. Now, let's go from there. You know what I'm saying? So, now I pay attention to you. So when a woman dealing with me, if it's one thing I've learned, and it's to growth though, don't get it twisted. I just didn't learn this overnight. It got to the point to where now, when a woman kicks it with me, it's like I'm her friend, like I'm really her friend. So, you know, that's what part of that team super single is that when you remove, you know what I'm saying, sex is the main focal point, and you start really get to know this, when you realize people that's worth your time and who not. You know what I'm saying? You realize who worth your time and who not. And you be like, I'm good. Like, you know what I'm saying? Yeah, the block one. Listen, let me tell y'all something. That's why I teach confidence. That's why I call myself, I'm supposed to be a grown person. Let me tell you something. That's the reason why I'm a confidence coach. Because I want you to have the confidence to be able to cut people off with no remorse. Real talk, though. To let you know that, man, you got a certain standard of your lifestyle. And therefore, you ain't going to settle for nothing. But the only way you can know what your standard is, you have to set the standard. And you have to set the standard, either break that standard or realize you need to add, you know what I'm saying, need to add to that. You feel what I'm saying? You need to add to that. So you got to keep pushing forward. Like, you got to make sure you where you going to be. You feel what I'm saying? Like, and that's what it took. I had to detox my whole mind and reframe my thought process. That's why you never seen me be bitter towards no woman. No matter what I've been through, you've never heard me talk derogatory about no woman. I don't talk derogatory about women. Because any woman that was bad to me, it was my choice to keep talking to her or cut her off. Like, for instance, let's get into it. I had some people that from the age of 36 to the age of 37 within this year range that I looked out for, helped out, and all that though. Appreciate the birthday love. I looked out for, helped out, did all kind of stuff that did not pick up the phone and tell me happy birthday. They didn't pick up the phone at one time and tell me happy birthday. I posted today. Didn't nobody say, listen. I swear for Lord, and this is everything I love. They good as block. Yeah, cause I don't play that. Cause one thing about it is I don't play when it comes to me. And that's why I want y'all to be. Hold people accountable. Because if a person can't think of you enough to even just tell you happy birthday, fine. I'm telling you what's real. Fine. Fine. You know what I'm saying? Fine. Because your time is so valuable that you took time out to help them. And they, like I say, you got to stop breaking your neck for people that won't break a fingernail for you. And this way, it ain't even no hard feelings. It ain't nothing. Because this is what I don't understand. Help me out with this. When people don't act right, and they don't call you, they don't talk to you, and then you block them, and then they had the audacity to say you wrong for blocking them. Well, you wasn't calling and talking to me in the first place. I just helped you out. Like, I just want to remove myself from the situation completely because I don't even want you having to worry about. Because, see, what happens is that this is what people don't want to talk about. A lot of times when people stop talking to you and stop spending time with you and stop doing stuff, and listen what I'm saying, they automatically don't want to talk to you. They just want to talk to you at their convenience. And they don't really know how to stop talking to you completely. And I believe that block button is here. God told me that this block button will bring us closer together. Because we'll both come to agreement and say, well, two are joined together in my name. I'm in the midst. So God told me, since you don't really want to talk anyway, let's just stop it all the way. Like, that's it. Let me, Blizzak. It ain't no hard feelings. And you know, and listen, it ain't no hard feelings. Because one thing about me, when it comes to the block button, I'm going to use it. Because what I do is that I don't just block you from my phone. I block you from all social media. And people be like, that's so petty. How is it petty? Because you giving them control. What kind of control I'm giving them? You feel what I'm saying? Like, what kind of control am I giving them? All I'm doing is removing myself. I see, because what I don't want them to do, I don't want them to see me on social media or anything like that. And then all of a sudden text me and be like, hey, big head. Hey, stranger. No. I'm going to keep them in peace and me in peace too. End of discussion. We're going to build a covenant with each other like God did with Abraham. But when he changed his name from Abram to Abraham, that's what we're going to do. We're going to build a covenant that thou shall not call me no more. Thou shall not be in contact with me no more. Thou shall move on with thyself. You feel what I'm saying? Because what I think about it, and I know this might be wrong with me, but I think about this here. I don't want you to feel like anything I post is because of you. Nah, you ain't that important. You ain't that important. I don't want you to feel like I'm posting and I'm trying to throw jabs at you. This way I block you. That means I would never show up on your timeline. My phone number would never show up with you. And you free to do whatever you want to do, baby. You free. Like Willie. Free like Willie the whale. Free. Do your thing. Yeah, that's it. And I'm because I'm confused. You didn't have enough audacity to call me. So what you want to talk for now? You're really not worried about me. You know what I'm saying? Listen. You do not listen. You really don't miss me. You really don't even want me. You know what I'm saying? Because guess what? The reason why it's like that is because you just a little. Your feelings a little bit because you know you blocked, so you feel some type of way. But hey, it's over with. He gave you the scissors to cut them. Yeah, it's all weird. That's it. And that's just real, man. I got 3 minutes left, man. I'm gonna get off at 8:45, man. I'm gonna get out for a second. That's it. I'm not going out like that. No. I'm going to get me a delicious Chipotle. I'm going to get me some delicious Chipotle to treat myself a little something. You feel what I'm saying? Let Chipotle. Y'all know. You know, I'm going to act up all this weekend. Can I post that on my story? I screen record it. Yeah. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? Yeah. Yeah, man. That's what it's here for. That's what you're here for. Like, yeah. Extra fajita. Look at you. Okay. You got a hungry spirit on you. I bind and rebuke that hungry spirit off you today. Glory be to God. I just subscribed to your YouTube channel. Appreciate it, baby. I'm going to tell you one more time. Happy birthday. Happy birthday, Sister Ellie. How you doing there, baby? Happy birthday. Appreciate you. Thank you. I was about to say that you should have birthday rewards from them if you had an app. I sure do have an app. Happy birthday, Joy Day King. Appreciate it. Appreciate it, baby. Thank you. After church dinner at Chipotle. Man, I'm telling you. I'm not finna act up. I'm not finna go in there. Cool. Extra. That's it. Extra. I'm good. Most certainly. I got to go to Shreveport just for Chipotle. You gotta go to Shreveport just for Chipotle. Happy birthday. I appreciate the love. Appreciate it, man. Appreciate the love. I'm telling you. I might go. I'm really thinking. I Monroe doesn't have. Oh, my Lord. Oh, my goodness. Monroe. I'm really thinking about going live Sunday when I be barbecuing. I might go live. Let y'all get a chance to see me cook this brisket. I might do Diverse Diva. What's up with you, baby? What the business is? What's happening? But yeah, though, that's it. I might go live for real, though. Make sure you get the dressing at Chipotle. Blessings and best wishes, friend. Man, I appreciate it. Man, I appreciate the birthday love. I appreciate all y'all. I love y'all to death. I love y'all. Many, many more loves. Many more loves. That's it, man. Happy birthday, Cinnabon. Okay, I see you, baby. Happy birthday. Y'all got to tell me what to get at Chipotle. Last thing I have I didn't like. Enjoy the rest of your birthday. I appreciate it. Yeah, it's 8:45. Let me explain something to y'all, man. Before I go, I got to give y'all a gem. I know we done laughed, we done played, and I appreciate all the birthday love. And my day has been wonderful. Tomorrow's going to be even greater because tomorrow's going to be the day after my birthday. It's a blessing that I got a chance to see every day. It's always a blessing. Every day that I wake up, it's a blessing. Every day that I wake up, it's another chance to lead somebody to Christ, do the things that God has for me to do. But before I go, man, I want y'all to listen to me and listen to me well. Create your life. I'm not just playing when I say that. I mean that. I mean that from the bottom of my heart. Create your life. Whatever you really and truly want, create your life to be that. Put a plan together. Write it down. Make the vision plain and clear. Cut off negativity out of your life. I want y'all to do that for me, man. That's from the bottom of my heart. Create your life the way you want it. Don't settle for nothing. Don't settle for less. Whatever it is that you really and truly want, don't settle for anything less. Go get that. Because life is such a beautiful and such a precious commodity. To be able to wake up is a blessing. Don't waste no more days. Focus on what it is that you want. Write your vision down. And if you don't have a vision, sit down in your room, cut the light off. And I know some of y'all might be scared of the dark. Don't cut no light off. Listen, get you a notebook and write down. I'm going to share something with you. Last night, I stayed up. I never stay up after my lies. I always go to bed after my lies because I get up and go to the gym. But I stayed up last night. I got up last night. Well, I stayed up last night. It was 11:58. I got down on my knees and I prayed. I prayed and I asked God for everything that I desired. I thanked him for everything in my 36 years on this earth. Everything that I've been through, everything that's happened. I asked him, I told him, you know, let me tell you something. When I told God, you know what I'm saying? When I told God, I want to forgive whoever hurt me. I want to let that go. Anything that may be on my heart, I want to let it go. Anything that might be holding on to. And I don't hold on to nothing, but I just want to make sure if there's any inkling of things that maybe I may be holding on to, let's let it go. Then I thanked him for all 36 years of my life. I thanked him for everything that he has done for me, everything he's allowed to happen to me, and everything that I got going on. Feel what I'm saying? No matter how positive my spirit is, I'm still human. And then after that, man, that's when I started asking him. And I told him, I said, you say I have not because I ask not. So I started asking for things that are so outrageous to where I know I'm going to have to go to the next level in order to go get them. But I'm cool with that because I'm just thankful to be alive. And I just know that there's so much more in store. I asked God for 1 million followers. I asked God for 1 million YouTube subscribers. I asked God for this to be the best show on the internet. I asked God to be signed, get my show sold. See, I could talk like that. I could talk like that. And the reason why I can talk like that because I believe in God. I don't believe in people. I ask God for this. And I ain't ashamed to say it. Because I know one thing. When I put it in God's hands, he going to do way more with it than any man or woman can do. He's going to do exceedingly abundantly and above all. Come on, man. Y'all feel what I'm saying? I ask God for everything. I ask God for me to be the best online coach ever. I ask God to be the best motivational speaker ever. I want to be the best because God wants to give me the best. And that's the reason why I'm so thankful for everything, because it's all part of the journey. And man, and let me tell you something. You're going to have to realize that you serve a God that wants to give you everything that you desire. He said he'll give you the desires of your heart. And the reason why you don't have it is because you really don't talk to God. You ain't told God exactly what you want. You hold back. You hold back. You be just you and God, and you still hold back. And God just sitting there listening to you like, man, I know she want more. I know he want more, but I don't know why he just holding back. You got to just tell him exactly what it is that you want. I wrote down details on what kind of house I want to live in. I wrote down details what kind of cars I want to drive. I wrote down details how much money I want to make. I wrote down details, baby. When he say write it down plain and clear, if you was to read my list, don't get it twisted. Not only did I ask that, I got a list that I'm making right now. I got a list. I'm at number 28 right now because I had to redo my goals. I had to redo my goals for this year. And I'm talking about I'm at number 28. And the things I wrote down everything in plain and clear. When I say plain and clear, I mean plain and clear. It's going to be some folks that going to look at some folks going to read that there and say, Lord, have mercy, Jesus. This boy, he really do got a relationship with God. Yes, I do. Because I believe that's the only person. Because God give you visions that you can't afford so you can know that it was him that did it for you. You feel what I'm saying? So I don't know about y'all, but I'm writing my list, and I'm gonna watch it come to fruition. He said, "For the vision is yet for an appointed time, for it shall not tarry." That means that it's gonna come at the right time. He said, "For the vision is yet for an appointed time." Habakkuk 2:2. It says that the vision is yet for an appointed time. That means it's a time and a season of everything under the sun, according to the book of Ecclesiastes. It says a time and a season for everything under the sun. Therefore, in Habakkuk, he said it's yet for an appointed time. So when the time come on now. He gonna give it to me. And when I get it, I'm gonna ask for some more. My God don't run out. I don't know about y'all. My God don't run out. Yeah, my God don't run out. When I get that, I'm gonna ask for something else. I ain't done. I got some more I wanna ask for. I don't know about y'all. Yeah, I'm gonna get some extra. You know, just like I'm gonna go to Chipotle, I'm gonna ask for a little extra. Cause they be stingy with that rice sometimes. They be stingy with it sometimes. But on that note, you feel what I'm saying? Well, on that note, man, I'm finna get ready to get up out of here, man. I appreciate the love. Thank you so much for spending my birthday with me. I'd be more than happy. I don't know. I might do a pop up show tomorrow. So just make sure you subscribe to me. And make sure you're looking out for me. This here will be posted on YouTube tonight. If not tonight, it'll be first thing in the morning. Cause sometimes it take forever to load. Cause I'd be almost 2 hours long. With those things being said, I got three things for you. I got three things for you. 37,000. You right, baby. 37,000 for a 37-year-old man. I appreciate it. Glory. That's a prophetic sign. Glory. But that being said, man, I got three things for you. God loves you. I definitely love you. And if we keep loving each other, the world's going to be a better place. I'll see y'all, I don't know, probably be tomorrow. Y'all have a blessed and wonderful night. All right, I love y'all.